Hello viewers, welcome to Chum's Creations. In my travel diaries, I am going to show you Sri Varaha Lakshmi Narasimha Swami Temple. This famous Hindu shrine located on a mountain in the Eastern Ghats is located at Simhacharam village, 11 kilometers from Visakhapatnam city. Firstly, we have to reach Visakhapatnam by flight, train or bus. Then Simhacharam can be reached by auto, cabs or bus. APSRTC runs buses from all over Visakhapatnam to Simhacharam and few buses go directly to the hilltop. After reaching Gopalpatnam junction, we can see on the right side temple arch and we have to pass through this. Have to take vehicle token and Dasaram tickets at Sridevi complex next to Simhacharam bus station. Ticket prices are Sigra Darsanam 100 rupees, Ati Sigra Darsanam 300 rupees and Kesha Khandana 25 rupees. Earlier 20 rupees tickets were available, but right now due to pandemic these tickets are not issued, and also free Darshan tokens have to be taken here only. Earlier, they used to give vehicle tokens at the entrance of the hill arch and Dasaram tickets at temple premises. But now, due to pandemic, we have to take all the tickets here only. If you have your own vehicles, you can pay a nominal toll fee. In Simhacharam, excellent accommodation facilities are available. Pushkarini Chowdhury and TTD Satrams are in downhill with basic charges. Chowdhury's cottages and guest houses are available on the uphill. Sri Varaha Lakshmi Narasimha Swami, popularly known as Simhadri Appanna by the people of the surrounding area of Visakhapatnam, resides in this shrine. The temple is located on the Simhagiri Hills at an elevation of 244 meters above sea level. Earlier, here idols of Swami used to be there, because if at all the devotees could not get darshan of Swami, they could have it here and do all puja rituals. They have removed and renovated steps path by the Devasthanam. Here, we can see the renovated arch to reach top of the hill through steps, and there are nearly 1000 steps. The temple runs 4 buses and bus is available every 15 minutes. Sri Varaha Lakshmi Narasimha Swami, the lineman incarnation of Lord Vishnu, is the presiding deity of the temple. If you see the aerial view of the mountain, it will appear like line. Here, this is the fourth incarnation of Vishnu Dashavataras as Lakshmi Narasimha. It is one of the important Vaishnava shrines in South India, the highest revenue earning temple after Tirupati. While starting to the hill on the left side, we can have Hanuman's darshan, which is of 20 feet. Simhacharam dates back to the 11th century. It is said that the Moolaviratu of this temple was actually erected by Prahlada himself. The idol appears to be a combination of the incarnation of Vishnu as Varaha and Narasimha to kill the demon brothers Hiranyaksha and Hiranyakasyapa. Swami has the face of a pig, the body of a man and the tail of a lion. According to a local legend, the temple, which was once worshipped during the reign of Prahlada, gradually fell into disrepair. One day, when Pururava Maharaja was passing through this place, Vishnumurti came to his dream and said that there was a lord under the mounds. The Maharaja took out the idol and cleaned it with Sahasra Kalasas. This incident took place on the third day of Akshaya. It is said that Pururava ordered the devotees to always cover Swami with sandalwood, as they could not tolerate the appearance of Swami, who was an aggressor. Since then, on every Akshaya Tritiya, the old sandalwood is removed and the devotees are allowed to see the real Swami idol for 12 hours. Then the Swami is anointed with Sahasra Kalasas and anointed with sandalwood again. This sandalwood paste is applied to Swami 4 times in a year. During those 12 hours, the climate of Simhacharam surroundings becomes very hot compared to other days. The triangular posture is to stand upright, lean to one side near the waist and keep the back neck straight. Apart from the occasion of Chandanotsavam, devotees flock to this place throughout the year. Devotees feel that the divine feeling is felt when they step on the hill, which is covered with sampanga flowers and palm trees. There are 41 steps to reach the temple from the top of the hill through the 8 tower. A lift facility is also there near the temple VIP stays for disabled and elderly people. Simhachalam is also home to many waterfalls, just like the one on the Tirumala Hills. Among them, Gangadhara, Aksharadhara, Madhavadhara and Chakradhara are prominent. Devotees reach the temple by bathing in these streams. There are about 252 inscriptions in the temple area describing the importance of Simhachalam. At present, children below 10 years, elders above 65 years and pregnant ladies are not allowed inside the temple. At the entrance, hand sanitizers are arranged by Devasthanams and we can also see here social distancing markings. After defeating Gajapati Prataparudra, Sri Krishna Devaraya visited the Lion Shrine in 1516 AD and 1519 AD and established some villages for the service of the Swami. He presented many valuable ornaments to the Swami. There is an emerald necklace in the temple. The family members of the Vijayanagara kings have been the hereditary trustees of the temple for the last two centuries. Dravidian Sri Vaishnava tradition can be seen in this temple. The main attraction in this temple is the entrance to the temple is west facing through the wind tower. Usually, all the temples we see are facing east, but Simhachalam is an exception. Devotees believe that visiting this west-facing temple will bring them success. The beautifully carved 16-pillared Natya Mantapa and the 96-pillared Kalyana Mantapa bear testimony to the architectural brilliance of the temple and is carved with Purana's depiction. Now, I am entering the main temple to have Lord's Darshan. I am sharing with you some real pics of Swami in the video as photography is prohibited. The speciality about this temple is that we can do pradakshina around the main idol inside the Garbhagudi. But right now due to pandemic we cannot have this darshan and we have to seek blessings from main entrance only. There is a frog pillar in the wall opposite the sanctum of the temple. This pillar is enshrined on the Santana Gopala Swami. Devotees believe that if the childless embrace this pillar, they will have children and also fulfill the pilgrim's wishes. It is also known as a frog pillar as the devotees pay kappas, that is tax to the Swami here. Over time, it became a frog pillar. Sanctorum wall panel relief possesses the sculpture of Lord Narasimha postures. A beautiful stone chariot which is pulled by horses is seen here. Devasthanam bookstall is available outside the temple premises. Here we get idol photos, books, etc. Sri Kasi Visveswara Panchayatana temple is a very old Shivalayam here. During Kartika Masam, devotees come and perform puja rituals. We can do Abhishekam to Shivalingam on our own. Now we are going to prasadam counters. We get laddu for 15 rupees and pulhora for 10 rupees as prasadam. Before pandemic, Kalyanam laddu was also available as prasadam for 50 rupees. Devotees are served Anna Prasadam every day at Anna Prasadasala by Devasthanam. But right now, due to pandemic, this seva is suspended for time being. today centuries old Swayambhu Lingam named Sri Tripurantaka Swami Temple on the way to Gangadhara. Varaha Pushkarini is located in the village of Adavivaram below Simhagiri Hill. Festivities are brought here once a year on the day of the Teppotsavam. There is a porch in the middle of this pond. In 2017, New Ghat Road was laid by the government near Adivaram Road to reach hilltop. I hope you all liked my video and information given about Sri Varaha Lakshmi Narasimha Swami Simhachalam. Keep watching my channel for more information and interesting videos. And don't forget to like, share, comment and subscribe to my channel Chups Creations. Thank you.